Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube with some tips on how to turn your model railroad from good to great. Let's start with track. This is Atlas Flex Track. It's good. The ties are black and they're shiny. The rail is also very shiny. Now, I used this Rust-Oleum, not my favorite, but any brown spray paint would work good. I had to do two coats. So here you see the untouched on the top and the painted on the bottom. You can already see that the side of the rails look good. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just go over it lightly with a little bit of gray that I mixed just with white and black acrylics, just to age it up a little bit. I make my own little cups of ballast. It's just combinations, everything from fine ballast of cinders to a sand color to like a light gray, a dark brown. I have medium grays. I just try different combinations. I use sometimes Woodland Scenics or Scenic Express. Now the top, I'm just simply using one color of ballast just to show the difference between just coming straight from the bag and doing one solid color, using a paintbrush to kind of get it in between the ties. Okay, so that's how it would look if you just did one color. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a small cup and I'm just going to make a small portion for this little piece of track. Obviously, if I was doing bigger, I would have a bigger container. So I'm mixing it up. It's just going to be a little bit of each of the ones that I've mentioned. I'm going more with a short line, maybe a class 2 railroad, where ballast has just been around for a long time. I use a spoon to go in between the rail. Just getting a little bit on the outside, not too much, and I'll explain why in a minute. So use the paintbrush to push the ballast between the ties. Now, I'm going to gradually add more and more of this green grass. I stir it up, and I'm just going to do just the outsides, where the grass and the weeds are starting to work their way into the ballast. It's not going to happen really in the middle of the track as much as it's going to happen on the outsides. The further away from the rail, the darker it'll get. Doesn't that look a lot better? Now I always use 50-50 on everything. 50-50 water and rubbing alcohol and an eyedropper. I go directly on the rail. I personally don't have a lot of luck with those sprayers with like a mister. So I just do what works for me, and that is the eyedropper on the rail. If you don't add either detergent or rubbing alcohol, the water will just bead over it. Now this is a 50-50 mix that I made of water and Elmer's glue. And this is where everyone goes, it's too thick. I know, but it will dry. So I do them both. And I'll let you decide. Personally, I like the one with the color. I think it looks way more realistic. And even with the engines on it, I just think adding some age and some color to the ties just really makes it stand out more. So let's take a look at some other things that are associated with track that we can fix up and go from good to great. This is the Cotto re-railer. It's good. It works really good for re-railing your cars. But I don't like the color. And there is some wood detail. Like this is supposed to be concrete with like wood planks. But it's like a olive drab. So I taped it to a piece of cardboard, took it outside, and spray painted it with primer. Now you have to use primer because a lot of this plastic, the paint doesn't stick to it unless you hit it with primer like I did here. Now I always use these cosmetic sponges and acrylic paints. This is just white and like a light brown. I mix together, and then you tap lightly, not hard, really lightly with this stuff. You probably want to do a couple coats anyway. Now, why I use this method is because you don't get brush streaks. I notice a lot of times when I paint, if I use a paintbrush, I'll get the streaks of a paintbrush. This gives you a nice flat look. And I'm making kind of like a asphalt, like a concrete type color. Yeah, I goofed up, I got a little bit on the planks, but I'll go over it. That's another nice thing about acrylic paints, you could just go over it. So I did pretty much the whole outside of it. I'm not too worried about being sloppy right now because I'm going to go over stuff. Now I use just regular brown paint and the paintbrush to paint the rails. I'm going to clean the rails, so yeah, you can paint over top of them, but eventually I'll use the Bright Boy cleaner, get the paint off. But I painted the inside of the rails and the outside of the rails with brown. Then I mixed some white, a little bit of black. It's hard for me to get a good like wood color. I'm kind of struggling. I'm learning how to mix paint, though, and only like a few colors here. So what I did is I used a paintbrush, got some white, got some brown, just a tiny bit of black, to try to get like a wood plank look. That's not perfect. If you can do better, great. But at least I want to show you the technique that I'm doing. So I just went back and forth with this brown color that I made. And I did anything that looked like plank, including the center. I made my own gray and kind of touched up in between. It's like a concrete there. Now, I had tried to make some skid marks for cars trying to hurry up and get across, left some skid marks. This is just extra stuff. I had some paint pens, just basic paint pens. I had one white, one yellow, and I made the center line. I made the white line to stop vehicles from going onto the tracks. But remember, it was that olive drab color, and now look how much better I think it looks with some details. So these are just simple projects. They're nice pieces. They just need some color. Now this next thing I want to show you. Atlas makes this bumper. And this thing's been around since before I was born. I never really understood it. Never paid much attention. Hey, it's just a bumper, right? Now, you can't make out any detail until you hit it with primer, like I did here. And now you can definitely tell the difference between what is made out of steel and what is made out of concrete. I still don't really understand that concrete block with a hole in it. I think some of them might have had light bulbs in it at one time. I'm not sure. I had to go with a paintbrush because the foam thing really wouldn't have worked that great, in my opinion, in this area. So I made my own concrete color. This is N scale. It's harder than you think. So I assume that this is concrete. Like I said, I'm not really sure, but let's paint it concrete and see what happens. Now for everything else, I just either painted brown to start with, or black. It's starting to look like something, but I wanted to weather it. And so I have, I think it's called terracotta. I just mixed that with some water, so it was more dilute, and then I just kind of ran it over both the steel and some of the concrete. Not sure why the camera got fuzzy for a second. Apologize. It'll clear up in a minute. But, it's a more diluted color. Just kind of let it run off. Because concrete does like have a rust appearance when it gets old also. And so final result. Actually, when it's dried, I forgot to take a video. When it dried, it looked way better. So there you got a nice bumper and how much difference paint can make to a model. Paint works wonders, and I'm still learning about paint, and that is why I partnered with Skillshare to be a sponsor of this video. Skillshare is an online learning community where you can take classes like I've been doing in everything from video editing and marketing, productivity, web design, and now I'm learning painting. It's great because there are thousands of courses with new ones being added all the time. There are no ads, and each lesson is straight to the point, which means you get a lot more done in less time. Now, I just finished watching How to Paint a Simple Acrylic Landscape Using Only 4 Colors by Veronica Zubek. I have to admit, I feel stupid because I have about 100 different bottles of acrylic paint in the train room when I should have probably been doing what she teaches this whole time. Skillshare is great for you and your family, and it's less than $10 a month with a yearly subscription. And since model railroading is a creative hobby, the first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will receive a free trial of the premium membership so you can explore your creativity. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my channel DJ's Trains because I got more great videos coming up. In fact, we're going to take a look at some places that you've never seen because I've never seen them either. And also I'm doing some traveling, so I'm going to have some travel videos. I'm doing some modeling, some scratch building, ways to save money. There's so much good stuff. So subscribe. If you haven't checked out my Patreon page, please do that because I got some great behind the scenes going on and a lot of good stuff. So thanks for all your support. I appreciate it. Bye.